many a poor boy. And God, I know I'm one. My mother was a tailor, sold my new blue jeans. My father was a gambling man down in New Orleans. The only thing a gambler needs is a suitcase and a trunk. And the only time he's satisfied is when he's on a drunk.
House of the Rising Sun. The band was called the Animals. The Animals. Anyhow, speaking about animals, Kempville Town needs a cat shelter for all the stray cats of Kempville and Kings County. Many stray cats freeze to death every winter in the town of Kempville and Kings County area. Why is that? That's because of our leaders' neglect. Yes, I've said it. Our leaders neglect. We need to start cat shelters for all these stray cats in the town of Kempville. We got numerous vacant buildings in the town of Kempville. Let's take one of those buildings for the stray cats and adopt the cats out into loving homes. That's Dennis Ramsey's message to Sandra Snow and Eric Boland, Kathy Maxwell, Lynn Potsifer, and the rest of the gang at the town hall at Kempville. Anyhows, please subscribe to my videos on the YouTube channel. There's talking videos, singing videos, art videos, and please help out the Canadian homeless folks this winter. Justin Trudeau and the federal government, please spend $2 or $3 billion on our Canadian homeless folks and get them housing and lodging. That's a message from Dennis Ramsey, so they don't freeze to death in the wintertime in Canada. Anyhows, that was called The House of the Rising Sun by the band The Animals. The Animals. What I like about the song is the organ. I like that organ sound. It sounds cool. Anyhows, please subscribe to all my videos on the YouTube channel. Always give me a thumbs up. None of these. Always a thumbs up. Dennis Ramsey is Nova Scotia's best living folk artist. Not only do I sell folk art paintings, I also paint abstract art paintings also. So you could also say I'm an abstract artist also. Anyhows, call me 902-365-5044, no jive. If you want a folk art painting or an abstract art painting, they cost only $100 each, up to $200 each. You can visit me at 27 Canaan, C-A-N-A-A-N Avenue, Apartment B, Kempville, yellow house, white trim. I live in the upstairs apartment. Anyhows, we're halfway through the winter. We only got February and March, then we'll get into the springtime in April. One nice thing about February, the days are longer and brighter. That's one good thing. This winter's going faster than last winter. That's why I'm not complaining about the winter. Because last winter it seemed to drag on and on and on. I never thought it was going to end last winter. But this winter's going pretty good. It's going fairly fast, so I'm happy about that. We're almost into February. And my birthday will be February the 9th, 2018. I'll be 54 years old. This February the 9th, 2018. So if you want to give Dennis Ramsey a present, please do so. Buy my paintings on February the 9th, 2018. I sell them for $100 each, up to $200 each. Come visit me at 27 Canaan, C-A-N-A-A-N Avenue, Apartment B, Kempville, yellow house, white trim. I live in the upstairs apartment. You can call me at 902-365-5044. Anyhow, my brother got me the internet, and he said, I'll keep paying your bill, providing you use it every day. So I do use it every day. I use it about 3 hours every day. So he said, it's good if you get something like that, providing you use it. So I do use it every day, about 3 or 4 hours every day. Anyhows, please subscribe to my videos on the YouTube channel and give me a thumbs up. And I'll keep making these short films. And I enjoy it. It's a hobby for me. It gives me something to do because I'm not allowed out Monday to Friday to do any folk art displays because of the yard sale bylaw, which the dummies at the town hall at Kempville made. It hurts all the yard sailors and the starving artist, Dennis Ramsey. They got nothing better to do at the town hall than make stupid yard sale bylaw, which says you're allowed out on Saturdays and Sundays to do your folk art displays. But Monday to Friday, if you go out there and do a folk art display, we're going to fine you $50 and give you a little scoring. Isn't that stupid? We're not that free in Canada or Nova Scotia. Our liberties and freedoms have been taken away by these stupid bylaws which all the town halls in Nova Scotia make. And believe me, they make some stupid bylaws. I've seen them. About 3/4 of the bylaws are stupid, dumbfounded. A lot of their bylaws are not constructive, and they're not even sensible. Anyhow, that's my opinion. I thought I'd share it with you. Please buy my paintings in 2018, and I'd appreciate that. Call me at 902-365-5044. Anyhow, my birthday is February the 9th, 2018. Yes, I'm a winter baby. So come buy my paintings from me, my folk art paintings and abstract art paintings. I charge only $100 each, up to $200 each. 902-365-5044. It's like God said, God helps those that help themselves. I know you've probably heard that one. So I've been trying to help myself by doing these videos for the YouTube channel. Because it's no good for me to sit there each day and complain, oh, I got a shitty deal from the town hall. Which I did get a shitty deal. I got a bad deal, I'm only allowed out on Saturdays and Sundays. Yeah, I did get a bad deal. Because Monday to Friday, I can't do no folk art displays. Am I mad about it? Yes, I'm angry, disappointed, frustrated, because it's a stupid bylaw. This yard sale bylaw is so petty of the town hall of Kempville. You mean to say the town hall of Kempville has nothing better to do than to make stupid bylaws? Come on, get off the pot. Why don't you replace the Cornwallis Bridge this spring and summer before an 18-wheeler goes into the river? Why don't you get a new mall or a new sports center, new factories, new jobs? Why don't you start restaurants in the town of Kempville? Why don't you have a superstore or Sobeys like the Minus? Why don't you make this town boom again like it did in the 1970s? Oh no, they don't want change, and they want this town to turn into a ghost town, which it already is in 2018. Kempville's a ghost town, and why is that? That's because we're poor leaders. I've said it, our poor leaders. That's Dennis Ramsey's opinion. Anyhow, if I was the mayor of Kempville, this town would be booming, thriving, and busy, busy, busy. There'd be factories, there'd be new jobs, there'd be restaurants, there'd be a mall, a sports center. I'd make this town boom, boom, boom. Presently, we got about 8,000 folks that live here. When I got done with it, there'd be about 50,000 people living here and operating different businesses, jobs, stores, and so on. Our current leaders don't want change, and the backbenchers at the town hall of Kempville are not developing the town of Kempville. I've said it. They're not developing the town of Kempville to its potential. Kempville has great potential if we have the proper leaders like Dennis Ramsey. I'm a man of action, and if I was the mayor of Kempville, this town would be great again and boom again. That's a fact. Because I would do something every day of the week that would help enhance the town of Kempville. There's 7 days in a week, so each day I would accomplish something for the town of Kempville. I'd make the town a better place. Our current leaders are sitting on their derriere and not developing the town of Kempville, and we're not moving forward. We're frozen in time. That's the best way to put it. Kempville is frozen in time, and it's a ghost town. They're not moving. They got to get their asses moving and get factories and jobs and restaurants, sports centers and malls. They got to be a word of action and not full of hot air. You got to start doing things. Start working towards making Kempville great again. New jobs, new businesses, new restaurants, new malls, new factories. There's a lot of young folks in this town that have nothing, no jobs, no opportunities. Anyhow, my time's up. Take care. Peace out. Have a nice day.